Helean, this is your Asian session preview for Wednesday, the 6th of October 2010. Welcome to FX Bootcamp. Please be advised the purpose is education, it is not an alert service. Coaches will not make trade recommendations. However, we will conduct technical and fundamental analysis of the live markets and help you construct trade plans throughout the course of the trading day. Please bear in mind, trading heavily leveraged is a very risky business. Also, past performance does not predict future results. Do not trade money you cannot afford to lose. Continued USD weakness, guys. This green line that you see on my screen, daily chart, this is just showing you on the Euro-USD. That was our next real line in the sand in terms of resistance. A lot of roll reversal in there over time, and a few other bits and pieces around that 136 region, and it's not even given us a pullback. I was still bullish on this pair, but I was at least thinking maybe we might get something like up to this region, like a nice little fib, and then continuation. But it's just continued riding this daily five straight through that zone. Just shows you how bearish the US dollar is right now and how we really need some fundamental news to break through this. To show you the Aussie dollar, we had a truckload of fundamental news come through yesterday, including the interest rate decision on the Aussie. They decided not to raise it, and it caused a little bearishness on the red candle through here. And all that's done in the context of the USD is it's given a nice pullback and an opportunity for people to buy this pair again, and off we go. Looks like to me, just looking on the 4 hour, I think this is where I'm going to base my little trade plans for the day. This 4 hour chart could quite possibly start doing something like this. Hello. Just a pullback, swing 4 hour, and go and make higher highs. And you know, within 24 hours from now, I wouldn't be surprised if we could be at a higher level than that, and one big step closer to parity. In fact, I think a decent fib swing on a 4 hour chart here, long, could get you there. So that's the sort of thing I'm going to be looking for today, is buying off the, you know, bias is obviously in this direction up, and it just shows you how strong this is when they threw us a carrot yesterday and said, here's a little bit of average Aussie news. We're not going to raise interest rates. Well, that's significant. That, to me, should have spelt like at least a fib of this rise. And then maybe some continuation. A little negative news, really, on the Aussie. It doesn't really look like it at all. This is pretty bullish engulfing what's happened in the last sort of 12 hours on this pair. So that's the way I'm going to continue. I'm going to assume that we're going to hold. This level of support's going to hold, and we're going to continue that. And I'm still looking for pullbacks on this 4 hour chart. Give me essentially, if we just go to the quote board and have a little look at it, bring up the Aussie dollar here. Also breaking through. You notice we're currently breaking through the weekly central pivot. And essentially, look where we've got long. Weekly extremes. Now we're breaking the central. And don't be surprised if by NFP we're somewhere up in this department here. Okay, remember NFP this week, guys. In a few days' time, so maybe by Thursday, expect the markets to get a little bit flat. And then we'll have to be hanging out for the news. This is what I'm going to look for on a 15-minute chart, guys, is something like this. We've got a fib of the rise here, and I'm going to look for the 15-minute, hopefully. I mean, this is still very much in an uptrend. Higher lows being printed all throughout the day, pretty much since London, and need a little bit of change in sentiment here. I'd like to maybe see, like, doing this video, a lower high here, pull back and just step this way down a little bit, and then essentially look to go back to a little uptrend down here somewhere where we can then look to get long again. And this area Here will be a new four-hour higher low swing. This is our swing. This one is our swing off the daily, and we're just going to continue riding this long for the day. Be up to yourselves when you want to get out of it. Maybe new daily extreme pivots. I like the idea of the weekly pivots, even getting this up to parity. I mean, that's 300 pips away, but I really think this pair is on a charge, and just the way it's reacting off the next level of support it's found, essentially, after the interest rate decision yesterday. Now it's getting long. All it's telling me, guys, is, in the context, is we've still got a lot of USD weakness, and maybe the Aussie is just a little bit relative weaker right now. I tell you what, that'll all be forgotten very, very quickly, and I think this Aussie, which I think is one of the relatively stronger pairs out there right now, will be just continuing that and be on a nice long charge for the days to come. A little update on the yen. Be honest with you, I've mentioned in previous videos, I have been waiting for 4-hour changes of trend on this to take a little shot long. We've had a few, and I have had a few shots long. We took a long through here actually in Asia as a group on Monday, and it actually worked quite well, and we planned it very well. We pretty much got out daily 5 to the downside where we expected, took profits. Some of us scalped that short for another 60 pips, and I myself who did that also longed it, thinking if we could break 84 we were going to go somewhere with this, but unfortunately just making new lower lows on the 4-hour now, so nothing to see here. This is actually essentially just looking on the daily chart. It's made a new, or it's pretty much about to make a new lower low with respect to this low through here, which I'm just going to highlight here, which essentially has completely undone all of Bank of Japan's intervention. And just proves that was a pretty much a big fat waste of time. Maybe they got what they wanted for those days out of here, and it's just going to be continued short. So no longing on the USD yen now. Pretty much, I think going to have to wait. I was waiting for 4-hour changes of trend. I'm going to have to wait for something like the daily to change trend now, and then look to get long. I'm not going to waste time and energy anymore looking at that when I can just easily go and continue to short it, or long the Euro, the Aussie, the Swissie. Just this green line here, guys, around this 96.23 region, that's all-time lows. Be mentioning a class, they are going to take that there. Well, it's only 10 pips away, and it's been hitting down there throughout the course of the day. No reason to look to long it, that's for sure. Just look for reasons to get short. Have yourselves a good trading day, guys. We'll give you another video tomorrow. Cheers.